What's going on, guys? Good morning to you. Welcome to another Fortnite video. Today, I just woke up and Fortnite has updated. So, we are covering the Fortnite update here first, probably 40 minutes late now. But anyways, so as soon as we hit Battle Royale, you're gonna see it. They have some new skins, even though these are leaked, so they're not released yet. The chiller is now available. I mean, I'm kind of late on that because they leaked it a bunch of time ago. But yeah, the chiller is basically, you know, this pad where you place it and it slows down people, I believe. Anyways, though, so the tomato head is back. I know that. Oh, it is actually here, but I do have that. Anyway, so we have some new emotes and some leaked stuff, but what is currently in the game is if you go here and you go to Playground, there is actually settings. And that's probably their biggest update on Playgrounds yet. It still doesn't allow you to save your maps, which sucks. But it's pretty good because look at this. So you can have empty shields. You can have half shields or full shields. So you start with the shields if you want it. You have the health. So it's basically the same. You can have one health. So that opens up to a lot of new game modes, actually. Drop items when eliminated. You can disable that, which is nice. Fall damage on or off. You have the gravity, so that's really cool. You can do moon game modes, as you guys know. You have normal gravity, low or very low gravity. So I'm gonna show you the very low gravity in a second. You have the day cycle, so that's nice. You can just have it set to day or night. They should have some more, like midday or midnight, you know, something. They need sunrise, sunset, something like that, I don't know. And then you have player and names locations set to team only, but you can change it to always show. So basically you can do like deathmatch. And it's actual deathmatch, so you can see people through the wall, kind of like Call of Duty, you know, they have the radar. So yeah, that's a really cool update to Playgrounds. But anyways, I mean, we are gonna try it out. But before showing that, I have the skins over here. As you guys can see, these are the data mined skins. And these are gonna be coming out. We have the names over here. It's from Reddit, as you guys can tell probably. So the female one is called Strawops. And Heyman is called this one. And they look pretty good, dude. Let's see, open link in a new tab. There we go. Yeah, so they do look pretty cool. They're obviously for Halloween. So, I mean, it's not bad at all. Because I like the... I don't know, which one would I buy, dude? I don't know. I'll probably get the male one. But they also come with their matching amazing back blink. So you have the male and female one. Do they have... Yeah, Hey Nest and... Birdhovel. So they do have names as well on these. It's pretty cool though. I like these, dude. I'm liking the skins, dude. Next one, we have the two gliders. So we have the cube glider, dude. That's the clickbait glider. I don't know. Fortnite just keeps coming up with this stuff. It's pretty cool. I like it. It's called the Dark Glyph, Dark Bomber glider, and another glider for the Scarecrow. So that's the matching for the new skins. And this one is just, you know, just a general clickbait. There is more things though. That's not even the end. They have the new pickaxe. They have the unicorn, demon unicorn pickaxe. And this, so that's kind of lit. Well, actually, thinking about it, how is this related to the cube, dude? I need to know. But anyways, they also have a new emote for next time. So it's going to be the T-pose. Chin up, arm straight, rarity uncommon. So I don't know. I mean, the tipos. I mean, I wanted a new dance, but you don't always get what you want. So that's for the leaked content. And now we're back to Playgrounds, and I'm actually gonna show it off because look, in the custom options there is a lot of cool stuff. So basically, if I want to make a thumbnail, I can just set it today. Player name locations. I mean, that's gonna be cool for the stream. We can have it to always show, and gravity to very low. Also, you can have it to always hide. If you wanted to do like a hide and seek game mode. So that's kind of nice, dude. You can do like a little hide and seek game mode. Like they do open up a lot. Like this might not seem like a huge update, but I can see so many more opportunities for mini games on this. So that's much better. So it's kind of cool they're doing that. So we can also check out the island, dude, because the island's been moving all day since yesterday. I did live stream it and it turned out it was a bit of a clickbait because it just started moving. And we don't know where it's going or where it's headed. But technically, the island would go probably the same path as the cube. I'll do a video on the theories. Dude, look at how far it is. Like, last night it was... Okay, so, if you guys missed it, I've been live streaming this island move. It started from Loot Lake, and then it went to the last place the cube was at. And now it's going to Shifty Shafts, which was the place before that. So it's gonna probably go the backwards way of the cube. I'm gonna do a whole video on the theories, but basically if you missed it, it was leeching stuff from this room and then it started moving this direction. Yesterday I streamed when it was over there, actually. And today it's actually so far away, dude. It's almost, like, look, it's going towards Greasy Grove. Well, I mean, you know, I wish it went through Tilted Towers, and I hope they do it, because that's gonna be so much fun. But yeah, let's drop. So now we have the low gravity enabled, and it's set to very low. So basically, we're gonna jump really high. It's gonna be kind of nice. Like, you can do a lot of game modes like that, because even just having the lake allowed for so many game modes where you can just bounce off and do stuff. And now you can just have the low gravity all the time. I wish they would have a toggle in game so you can change it. So if you're the host, let's say you press escape and change it over here somewhere. But I mean, that's probably really hard to make, so they haven't made it yet. Maybe in a few weeks, saving the maps would be really cool as well. Like, that's gonna be a big one. But anyways, wait, let's see if I just shoot up because of the gravity being low or... Oh, wow, it just goes really slowly. Wow. All right, so yeah, basically the islands over here, you know, the basement, it hasn't really changed. So nothing's changed in the basement. You have the sound though. Listen, guys. Wait, I mean, I'll open the chest so you can hear it. The tornado is going like much faster. Yeah, it is, dude. That's cool. Oh, oh my God. That's a supply drop, but that's fine. Anyways, yeah, look at the low gravity, dude. Look at it. Oh, oh my God, dude. That is actually the definition of very low gravity. That's, you jump so high. That is cool though. You can explore, you can go around, you can go fast. You can, it's good for making thumbnails too. So that's kind of nice. You have the island in here. Wait, the cube, it seems a little bit smaller, but I'm really not sure because I look at it for so long that I can't even tell anymore. All right, we got some supply drops. So we would even go through Greasy. Well, it's gonna be close, dude. It's gonna be fun to play in the next few hours, I think. And also expected. So if you're watching the video when I upload it, it should be like 10 more hours until the island goes to the next location. So, and this is gonna be the next location. I mean, that's almost confirmed. So it's gonna go between Shifty Shafts and Greasy Grove, and the entire island is gonna start leeching something from the rune. And I can't tell, like, I thought the island would change or something, because it's been a while and it went to the first rune, and I don't know, it hasn't really done much. It looks almost identical. I mean, the basement changed with the rocks. So today we're probably gonna get some more island changes, and it's gonna be right over here. We're gonna have the little craters. I mean, they've started forming, dude. I mean, in this, there's probably gonna be jump pads and stuff. You know, the jumping, the purple jumps. So that's a really cool update. And then you get to open this chest. And I mean, these chests are just gonna probably, you know, get lifted up by the island again. So that's gonna be interesting to see. I'm gonna be live streaming this tonight. So if you're not subscribed to the channel, please subscribe, leave a like. And that almost covers all the information about the new update. And it's really cool. I would like to see the dance. I went on Reddit and checked. There is some other changes. Some people were saying the game on PC doesn't work as well as they want it to work. And, I mean, mine works fine, dude. I mean, just damn haters, dude. I mean, it works amazing. And yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it for all the updates on patch 6.0.1. It's really cool. I can't wait to see where the island goes, because that's honestly the best addition. And also, I mean, with this low gravity, you can even build. Like, I think that would be way easier to build maps. They're kind of making it easier and easier to build maps. And then eventually you'd be able to just go and build stuff and maybe make maps, dude. It's because look at this, with the low gravity you can just build an entire wall just like this, dude. That's so easy. Like, just, you can actually go so high, and you couldn't previously do this. This would take so much time because you would have to build it with the, you know, the staircase method like this. And yeah, I'm almost good at building now. I don't know, I played a bunch and I'm not too bad, actually. I had like 10 kills one of the games I played off cam, and that's decent, dude. I'm getting better at Fortnite, actually. All right, so that is the max height. It's just a little bit of the island. But yeah, look at that. You just built that. And if you want, you can just finish it. You can literally make buildings like this. Oh my God, dude, that was almost super fast. I forgot to disable fall damage. No, dude. But you can do that now. Oh, look at that. My tower looks cool, dude. Oh no, I shouldn't have opened the glider. That's gonna take a lot of time. But anyways, guys, that's gonna be it for today's video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to hit the like button. Stay tuned. I'll be live streaming this island moving. It started moving much faster than yesterday night. So next time I would know when exactly to stream it. But it's pretty hyped. I love the island. I like the new updates. They're actually bringing stuff to the game that people ask for, so that's nice. Because these options, like, I can see so many more game modes like this. Like, this is crazy. Because look, even just building, it's so much easier now. Because otherwise you would have to play, so you can literally just make the skyscraper without all the stuff in the middle. Because you can just jump and build it. So that's, I mean, that's, that by itself is a huge update. And it just, they make a nice quality of life changes, I guess. So, yeah, look at that, dude. You can literally just jump three times, have a stupid skyscraper, dude. That's kind of crazy. Yeah, look at this. Oh, dude, if you're good, you can probably just build it with two jumps or something, too. Oh, here we go. But, yeah, look at this. Like, can you imagine people making maps with this? It's gonna be, like, the scale, they can just go really high. And it's gonna be crazy. So, once they enable saving, I hope they do. It's gonna be great. But yeah, anyways, guys, please leave a like if you enjoyed this video. And I'll see you next time. So yeah, dab. Dab on the haters. Dab. Okay, no, never mind. Alright, see you guys.